Good evening. South Australian authorities have slammed shut our border with New South Wales as Sydney's COVID crisis escalates.
The snap travel ban causing chaos at Adelaide Airport, with those arriving corralled by police, then ordered immediately back out of the state.
Confusion, disappointment and frustration for these Adelaide arrivals. Their Qantas flight from Sydney touching down just after the South Australian border was slammed shut to New South Wales.
They waited till we landed to tell us we weren't allowed in. Ask me how that works.
Starting a new life here, and I really hope this doesn't stop that.
Passengers only learning of the sudden border closure upon arrival here. A not-so-warm welcome by waiting police.
So I am essentially non-essential entering here. I have to go back to Sydney. Got my COVID results back this morning and it said negative. And for this now,
you're going to have to come with us, thanks.
The announcement was made while the aircraft was halfway between Sydney and Adelaide and with immediate effect.
I think by now most people would have realised that the situation in New South Wales is deteriorating.
We do appreciate that this does cause a significant imposition on people, but the reality is we are dealing with a highly infectious virus, a particularly difficult strain.
The police commissioner using his powers to make the rare move of issuing a verbal directive even before it was signed off. Officers positioned at the border to watch over those arriving by road, those at the airport assessed on a case-by-case basis.
It may be that they have to quarantine or return, or they may be permitted to travel based on their own individual circumstances.
Some, furious to learn, they now face 2 weeks quarantine.
I work with words and words can't describe what I'm feeling right now. So I've been told that I can't even sit in the same level of seating with my mum.
Others sent packing.
I'm about to book another flight to go home straight away.
The door firmly shut on the eve of the school holidays to anyone from New South Wales and anyone who's been there in the last 14 days. A 100-kilometre buffer zone in place for border communities. Exemptions to only be granted for returning South Australians and exceptional circumstances.
And the reason for this is because of this quick spread that we are seeing, and also the fact that a number of these cases are currently unlinked.
Sydney recording 16 new COVID cases, 8 attended a party. The source of 4 remains unknown. The dangerous Delta variant cluster no longer exclusive to the Bondi area. The list of exposure sites growing rapidly.
Our contact tracing has been better than I've ever seen, but what we haven't seen before is the contagiousness of this variant of the virus.
It's not only flights from Sydney that are being affected tonight, but passengers that are arriving on flights from Queensland are also being pulled aside. That's to check if they have come either from New South Wales or have travelled through New South Wales. As for how long this border closure is going to last, authorities say they're not only looking at the number of cases that are popping up in Sydney, but also how this virus is spreading and where those cases are popping up. There are several cases without a known link that are causing concern. So, Brenton, this is a day-by-day proposition.
Thank you, Ed. Now, despite the border closure, the Sydney football team is still being allowed in. Will Crouch, SA Health, is standing by its decision to grant an exemption.
That's right, Brenton. The Sydney Swans football team will be allowed into the state to take on Port Adelaide on Saturday afternoon. That's after they flew out of Sydney and into Melbourne late last night, just before restrictions changed. Now, SA Health says the team will only be allowed in if they can follow some very strict rules, including isolation, testing and flying in and out on the same day. Making that a little easier is the change of time for that game. It's been shifted back from 7:10 to 4:05, so Sydney can fly out immediately after the game. But there are still some minor details being looked at, including whether or not further restrictions are needed.
We'll continue to discuss this with the AFL around this particular exemption that was given and what additional precautions or additional requirements may be required to ensure the safety of the South Australian community.
So Sydney will need to tick all the boxes to come into South Australia, and authorities will be keeping a close watch.
Will, thank you.